Minnesota, AP. The best formula for success against the New England Patriots is to keep Tom Brady on the sideline and harass him when he's on the field. That's not a newsflash, but the good news for Eagles fans and everyone rooting against Brady, Bill Belichick and the Patriots in Sunday's Super Bowl is that Philadelphia has the ingredients to do it. The Eagles, 15-3, have a multidimensional, ball control offense capable of chewing the clock and forcing no. 12 to be a spectator. Jay Ajayi, former Patriots running back LeGarrette Blunt and Corey Clement led the NFL's third best rushing offense and the Eagles were first in time of possession. You have to stay patient and diligent there, Eagles coach Doug Peterson said, that's something we've been able to do all season long. It's something we stay committed to. This isn't an old school, ground and pound offense. Either. The Eagles have a versatile passing attack with several receivers who create matchup problems. Carson Wentz threw for 3,296 yards and 33 touchdown passes before he tore his ACL in Week 14 and Nick Foles has 8 TD passes, including playoffs. Foles proved in the NFC Championship game he can make quick strike plays, with 3 passes of 40-plus yards against the league's top-ranked defense. 2 of those were TD tosses of 53 yards to Alshon Jeffrey and 41 yards to Torrey Smith. Pro Bowl tight end Zach Ertz and slot receiver Nelson Aguilar are other options. Tight end Trey Burton, who also lines up at fullback in certain short yardage situations, had 5 TD catches this season. You can't just stop one guy. Patriots safety Devin McCourty said, you can't go out there and say, if we just limit Jeffrey or if we just limit Ertz that won't matter. They have a lot of different guys out there that can beat you. Foles has been adept at making the right calls on run-pass option plays, making it even more difficult for defenses facing Philadelphia. It's hard because you have to defend every inch of the field, McCourty said. Each guy has to do their job on the play. We can't have guys doing things that don't fit the defense. On the opposite side of the ball, defensive coordinator Jim Schwartz has an aggressive unit. Nobody runs on Philadelphia's defense. It was no one against the run and didn't allow a 100-yard rusher until Ezekiel Elliott had 103 in Week 17 against backups and third stringers. The Patriots, 15-3, rely mainly on Brady's arm. Even though Deion Lewis had 896 yards rushing and James White was a Super Bowl hero last year, but Brady can't throw if he doesn't have time and the Eagles have a dominant front four led by Fletcher Cox and Brandon Graham. The line often generates enough pressure that Schwartz doesn't have to blitz much and there's enough depth with Chris Long, Vinny Curry, Tim Jernigan and Bo Allen of guys stay fresh in the fourth quarter. Safety Malcolm Jenkins is a physical presence in the secondary and cornerbacks Ronald Darby and Jalen Mills are solid cover guys. They have a great defense, Brady said. It's as good any we've faced all year. They have a great scheme that mixes in well with their coverages. If the game comes down to a field goal, rookie kicker Jake Elliott has a strong leg. He kicked a 61-yarder at the end of regulation to beat the Giants. In Week 3 and his 6 of 7 from beyond 50 yards, the Eagles shouldn't be tight and they're not intimidated by the Patriots. They're a loose, relaxed group that has embraced their underdog role throughout the playoffs and overcame injuries to several key players. Greatest quarterback of all time, but that doesn't mean that he's unbeatable, Jenkins said of Brady. We're not worried. We match up well. Matthew Emmons, USA Today Sports, Matthew Emmons.